Are you a Rasta yourself?
Yes, I'm a Rastafarian, and I think what a lot of people don't understand is that this is not a religion. This is a way of life. You know, religions is rule, rituals, and regulations. And religion, we know that really create majority of the division that we face. So being Rasta is not a religion, because we speak of one love, you know what I mean, amongst all. So being Rasta is how you live, you know what I mean? It's how you live with the neighbor, it's how you live within yourself. You know what I mean? It's how you govern yourself and you know, and that is in a righteous light, that is where your conscience is the ruler. That is where your conscience governs and guides you.
Well, what is the significance of dreadlocks in Rastafari?
It's just your identity. You know what I mean? This is just to make you know that this is who I am. You know what I mean? Because a lot of people wear dreads, so it become a fashion statement. But back then, right. It was just to identify with, so we know who we are.
Originally, there was a lot of persecution, mm-hmm. when in Jamaica, you know, men who wear their dreadlocks.
Yeah, in the early years, Rasta was considered black art man. Mm-hmm. You know, people who believe in a wickedness and who work black magic and all kind of things, you know. And you know, them time that we were the absolute opposite, Rasta has always been the set of people who fight against injustice. You know what I mean? Who rise up when everyone else was quiet. And make the world and everyone know that, you know, there is injustice taking place here, there, and afar. And so, you know, and when you find that people speak out against, I guess, what society wants us to be, then you find that those people will always get a fight.
It seemed that Bob Marley was willing to die for his beliefs, you know. It's, there was a couple, you know, you see certain times throughout his life where he put himself in danger.
Yeah, of course, but yeah, because when you speak out against society, when you speak out against heads of government, that is exactly what you do. You know what I mean? You put yourself in danger, and when you are a revolutionary, then you are always prepared to die, because that comes with the territory. You know what I mean? So once you get involved in certain things, and to the depths that my father got involved, then, you know, he knows that a part of it is that you're putting your life and the ones around you in danger. And
right.
Ultimately, you know what I mean, him pay that price to when them try to kill him early out in them, you know, in the early years.
Right, before the concert.
Right.
For the peace concert. He brought together the two political leaders.
Yeah, Mike and Manley and Edward Seaga. My father's passion for people and love for people is very different, because even for me, when, you know, I'm able to still go and hear some of the stories about when you say hundreds of people, you know what I mean, who line off the street and come round in at the gate to see him fit. Whether it be lunch money or school fare or, you know, whatever it may be. So this man's passion and love for humanity in general was, you know, something very special. You know what I mean? And those are still the things that keeps him so relevant till to today. You know what I mean? That is the energy that he left behind that is still very alive and very vibrant around us.
How many different businesses do your brothers and sisters have? I feel like I always see something Marley, you know.
Yeah,
I know you guys don't just let anyone do that, you know. Yeah, I know you guys keep very tight.
We probably open a new business every other week.
Every other week there's a new Marley business?
I mean, that is what life is about, ain't it? It's about expanding, it's about growing, it's about revolutionizing, it's about...
What are some of the bigger businesses that your brothers and sisters have started?
I mean, whoa, bigger? Everything Marley, you know, so I don't know if anyone is bigger than anyone. but, you know, my older brother Ron Marley does Marley Cafe.
Right, I've definitely heard of that.
Yeah,
which seems to be very successful.
It's doing great, yeah. You know what I mean, and it continued to grow. You know, there are so many other ventures, you know, the family is a part of the House of Marley brand. And everything Marley. You know what I mean? Everything Marley. And then besides that, you know, we get involved with a lot of different charity organizations, you know, continuing our father legacy as far as giving back, you know what I mean, and make sure that we try to provide opportunities and open doors where there are no doors being opened and where there are no opportunities being provided. So sure. That is a part of who we are.